In this video, we're going to talk about tracker item templates. In Codebeamer, users have the option to create tracker item templates based on already existing tracker items. This way, specific field values of a given tracker item can be saved as a template for extended reusability when creating new items. All configured tracker types support the creation of item templates, except document and test run type trackers. We're going to see how to create new item templates, how to use them, and how to manage those templates. So in Codebeamer, let's select one of our trackers. In our scenario, we're going to use the customer requirement specification. So let's open that. We have several ways to create the templates from. First, I can right-click on one of the items in the left side here, and the last option is going to be Save as Item Template. I can also select one of my requirements in the middle section, click on these dots on the right side, and select Save as Item Template. We also have an additional one, so let me open the detail view for the currently selected requirement. Now we have the option to create the tracker item template from here as well. But before doing so, let's modify a couple of fields so we can really see the usage of the item templates. So first of all, let's select the type. I'm going to select functional. Let's assign a theme as well. I'm going to pick the architects. For the customer status, I'm just going to select new. And I'm going to assign this to myself. This means that when I create the template from this item, all of these fields are going to be pre-populated when it comes to using the tracker item template. Now that we have our changes, let's go ahead and save this as a new item template. Here, I have to provide a name for the template, which is going to name it My Customer Requirement Template. I'm then going to save it. I didn't make it public because it's going to be assigned to me whenever a new item is created with this template, so this is a template for myself. Now, let's use our template. In the top left corner, we have the option to create a new item from a template. Once that's clicked, we're going to see the list of available templates. In our case, it's going to be one private template, the My Customer Requirements template that we just created. So let's select that. Once that's selected, we're going to see a window where we can provide the details for our requirement. Once that's selected, we're going to see a new window where we can provide the details of our requirements. The values that we set previously, for example, type, theme, customer status, and assigned to, these values are already populated for me. So the only thing that I'm going to do is change the name. I'm just going to call it New Custom Requirements Demo, and I'm going to change the description to be done. I'm going to click Save. And now my new customer requirement is created, and I didn't have to fill all of these details because I was using my template. Let's go back to my tracker, and let's see how to manage those templates. So if I click on More, I have the option to manage item templates. So let's check that. Here, we're going to see all the private and public templates. As we saw previously in our scenario, we only have one private template. With this X button, I can delete this template, but I also have the options to edit the template. So let's do that. We're going to be prompted to a new window where we're going to see all the values that are pre-filled. At the top here, we have a filter, so currently it's set to all, but I can filter on the editable fields or on the required fields only. So let's go back to all for now. What I'd like to change is that I don't want all of my requirements to be named reliable low beam operation, so I'm just going to change it to new requirement. This way, I'm going to see that I need to change these values when I'm creating the new requirement. For a description, I'm just going to remove the description. So we are starting with an empty description. Let's hit save. Now that my template is updated, let's create a new item using this template. I'm going to click on the new item from template button, click on my template, and we can immediately see that the title says new requirement and that the description is empty. So I'm just going to change it. Requirement from edited template. I'm going to save it. And if we take a look at the details here, all of the values like function assigned to team or customer status have been populated.